Good evening, I'm Udhar Pratap Singh. You're watching NewsX. Our top focus remains Karnataka, where complete pandemonium was seen on the streets of Bengaluru, while uncertainty in the Vidhan Sodha also prevails. The Bengaluru police have imposed Section 144 in the city to ensure no chaos takes place. This after violent clashes between the BJP and Congress JDS were reported from Racecourse Road, where the independents are all holed up. The JDS and Congress supporters were blocking the independents' way to the assembly, forcing the police to impose the curfew, which will continue now for the next 48 hours. Chief Minister Kumaraswamy, meanwhile, continues to speak in the House in a poignant address to the assembly. He spoke about how he was a reluctant chief minister and was pushed into it. He further said he was ready to sacrifice his chair, raising speculation over who would be the next chief minister. The Congress is all ready to go in for a division vote now for the no confidence motion in a bid to build a strong ground for disqualification of MLAs. It remains to be seen what will happen next in the Vidhan Sodha. And joining us live this evening will soon be Harish Upadhyay from Bengaluru and my colleague Mughalin as well. But let's also open this up to a special panel. We have Neeti Jain, a spokesperson of the BJP, with us. Rather, she has left us. So we will soon be joined by Gopal Krishna Agarwal of the BJP. And Nishant Verma, political analyst, also joins us live. S. Murari, political analyst, is still with us. Venkat Narayan, senior political commentator, live with us. And Shri Krishna, senior journalist, also joins us in our studio. Let me get you in here first, Mr. Murari. What do you make of this ongoing drama in Karnataka, which just doesn't seem to be ending? We're seeing now Kumaraswamy's speech. He has given indications of him perhaps ready to resign. But is this just more drama, sir?
If he wants to resign, why does he have to go on talking, prolonging the inevitable? He should have put in the papers. But he has to make up. Actually, it's an election speech. Preparing the ground, going to the people, these are the reasons why I have to resign. Obviously, he cannot face the assembly. He doesn't have the numbers. As I say from the beginning, it's just like Yediyurappa will go the Yediyurappa's way. That brings it to another point. If this government goes, as others said, it will not lead to dissolution of the assembly. After Bombay judgment, that cannot happen. The next biggest party, BJP, has to be called. And the BJP cannot ethically call Yediyurappa again to be the chief minister candidate because he has already lost. He didn't face the assembly like Kumaraswamy, whatever. So he does have somebody else. But one point I have to make is these 15 MLAs, they have not attended the assembly. Technically, if they don't attend the assembly also, they are liable for disqualification. But because of Supreme Court ruling, no, as Pranagnarayan also pointed in an earlier debate, no whip has been issued. So they can stay away from the house. What will happen? The effective strength will come down. On that, the effective strength we have seen already, JDS Congress doesn't have the numbers, don't have the numbers, they have to quit. But one point is, it is not in BJP's interest to get them disqualified. We have seen what happened in Tamil Nadu. 18 members were disqualified. They did not even resign. They petitioned the governor. On the ground, disqualified, and the strength also came down. If you are disqualified, immediately you'll go to court and get a stay. And the case will go on. It went on for nearly 2 years. Only along with the Lok Sabha, these 18 assembly seats, along with four others, were filled. In that, ADMK won 9 and got the required number. Now only it has a majority. For all these months and years, it has been carrying on with the forking majority. That cannot happen in Karnataka because BJP definitely will stroke a claim. And my reading is these 15 by-elections will hold key to future. And BJP and election commission will hold the by-election when it pleases the BJP. That is what has happened here. That's what is going to happen in BJP also. That is the position now. Anyway, this uncertainty immediately is not going to end. There will be a collected government now. BJP will step in. But how long is it going to be there? That's the question. These 14 MLAs seats will decide. They cannot vote right now. If they are members, even if they resign, the government.
What is delaying the inevitable?
What basis can they extend?
Mr. Murari, what is delaying the inevitable? Is it just to get that whip in force? Is it just to get that whip in force to prevent these rebels from possibly becoming ministers in the Yediyurappa's government? What is delaying the inevitable, according to you?
No. It's not. They have painted themselves into a corner. They have submitted the resignation. Now, what basis can they support the next government? They cannot. Obviously, the governor will call BJP. And existing strength only they can prove majority. These fellows cannot give letters of support to the BJP because they are no longer members of the assembly. Prima facie. Once it is accepted, the seats will be declared vacant. This is a very conundrum, constitutional conundrum that it will not resolve easily. Very peculiar situation. But as of now, BJP, it is BJP's advantage to go by the existing strength. Leave them aside, go by the, that is their plan, because unlike in Goa, where there are only 15 MLAs, they were able to lure away 10. Here the numbers are more, they just got away only 10 or 15, that's not enough. Anti-defection law will come into left, and if they go, openly go with the BJP, as they have done already, if they go or vote with the BJP or join this government, automatically they will be discussed. They cannot even do that. The governor cannot even accept that. That is the situation. But with the existing numbers, that is minus these 15, BJP has a thin majority, or one or two, and that will carry on, as I said, till the next by-election. New election, sooner or later, the resignation will be accepted, and the seats will be declared vacant. And if they go, they're disqualified, then as I said, what has happened in Tamil Nadu, will repeat, they'll go to court and get a stay, and it will be prolonged. The by-election will be prolonged. If they don't do that, then immediately, within 6 months or 1 year, elections are to be held. That is where the real test will be held. Whether the BJP people, what the people think of the BJP and the Congress and all this drama. That way, maybe 1 year down the line. That's my prognosis. So I don't know what is going to happen. It's only a matter of one day. We have waited so long. Let them talk as long as they can. Finally, we have to face the inevitable.
Okay. Mr. Verma, yes.
I would like to pick from where Mr. Murari has pointed out about the Ms. S.R. Bommai judgment of Supreme Court. I personally have gone through the Sarkaria Commission report, the Panchi Commission report, especially the S.R. Bommai. Murari sir, something that I failed to understand, probably you can guide the nation in fact on this. See, if a single largest party, yes, or a coalition, dependent on those four or five aspects that all of these three things consider, the Sarkaria Commission, the Panchi Commission and the S.R. Bommai judgment, now once a party or a coalition post or pre has already stake claim and has not been in a position to either prove it on the floor or has run away from it through resignation, what happened in May 2018 in Karnataka with BJP. Now the second largest group staked, yes, claim and is in power. Now they are collapsing. Under which section of the S.R. Bommai judgment or the Sarkaria Commission report or the Panchi report does the governor have the powers to call the first party or the coalition which failed, resigned and paved way for the next ones, which we are seeing in the assembly today, that the governor can call them again? Murari sir.
Yeah, can I clarify?
Yes, quickly, Mr. Murari, and then let me also bring in Gopal Krishna Agarwal of the BJP.
Resign. Yeah, very, very briefly I'll say that. If either Kumaraswamy resigns or he is voted out, the effect is the same. Then the governor has only option, as the Sarkari Commission and Bombay judgment, the test should be, the strength of an assembly should be the government or party claiming to say form government should not be tested on the lawns of the Raj Bhavan. It should be tested only in the assembly. So if he fails to prove majority, if he gives up also, the option before the governor is very limited. You try to put up the dissolution of the assembly till the last stage. So the next majority, largest single party is BJP. Obviously has to call. It has 105 plus two independents. So 107. Under the reduced, and these people, if the fate of these 15 MLAs remains uncertain, that becomes a grey area. They are disqualified. If they are absent, that is working strength. If they continue to be, they cannot be continued to be absent even after BJP comes to power. At the same time, they cannot go and support BJP also. This is why I said they have painted themselves into a corner. This backfired on the, in the long run, it has backfired on the BJP, the strategy. Yes, because in Goa, it succeeded because it's a small party. Here is a bigger numbers, so it could not break. One third you have to constitute a break. There are only 10 or 15, about 70 or 80 Congress MLAs are there. It's not going to happen. So Congress immediately will push for disqualification. No, it may take longer because once you lose power, what does it matter how long it takes? Till then, this government will continue on the basis of working compromise. As this is exactly what has happened in Tamil Nadu. On the, because the constitution says is, you have to prove your majority in the assembly on the basis of numbers present and voting. That is what's called working majority. That will happen in Karnataka also. In the immediate future. Later on, when the by-elections are held, then it will be a different situation. Who wins, whether the BJP or the Congress, in the majority of seats. That's why I say ultimately the by-elections will decide whether what has happened, what the people think about the ugly happenings here, horse trading and all that. That's my situation.
This is the report. Murari sir, I just wish to make a small observation here. Probably the question that I asked was about the Sarkaria Commission, Panchi Commission, as well as the SR Bomai, which probably you did not respond to. I'll tell you why. Because if we remember, not the 13-day Sarkar, but the 13...
Yeah, Sarkaria has three grounds. One, if you voluntarily...
Okay, now we need to... Let's come back to the issue. That is finished
very
now.
Important
there's no point going back
the 13
in the past.
The
there's no point going back in the past now. Gopal Krishna Agarwal of the BJP, come in here. Gopal Krishna Agarwal of the BJP, come in here. The drama continues. No trust vote in sight. Kumaraswamy's speech continues. He has said, he has made an emotional pitch. He has said he's ready to resign. He was forced into this post. He will not run away. He has his resignation letter in his pocket. What do you make of this speech by Kumaraswamy, Mr. Agarwal? And what is going to be the BJP strategy if even today we do not see a trust vote in the next couple of hours?
Udayji, the issue is not how emotional Kumaraswamy is and what speaker is saying. This is all drama.
The speaker also has said he's willing to resign,
they
sir.
They don't have the majority. What is the question today? Who is stopping him to resign? Just keeping a resignation letter in your pocket doesn't mean that you are ready to resign. If you are ready to resign, resign. The issue is very clear. When Mr. Kumaraswamy at the floor of the house at present does not enjoy the majority of the assembly, he is in a minority. He has no right to continue as the chief minister of Karnataka. And if he is trying to continue as such, he is just killing the democracy in the Karnataka state. The speaker has a responsibility that those the person who have been asked, chief minister, if he has been asked to prove his majority at the floor of the house by the governor, then speaker should execute that issue. But he is not doing it. So neither speaker is doing his duty, neither Kumaraswamy is working in a democratic way. They have lost the majority. Now, I would like to mention that there has been on the panel, people were saying about SR Bommai, Panchi Committee and Sarkaria Committee, all the constitutional decisions cast the responsibility on the governor to exhaust every way how the government can be formed on the assembly after an election is conducted. And this is at a point of time. If the BJP earlier lost, did not have the majority, Mr. Yediyurappa resigned. But the whole situation is now changed. That time there was an alliance of Janata Dal S and Congress, which has now failed. They have only 101 MLAs and BJP has 107. Yes. So who has the majority and who is in the minority is crystal clear. So whether BJP is able to form the government is not the question. The question is Mr. Kumaraswamy has lost the majority, and if he claims to be having majority, he has to prove. So that delaying is killing democracy and is a shame on the democracy of Karnataka. This the people are watching. No amount of drama will help anything.
Ulta chor
Nishant Verma is giving a direct response to you.
Ulta chor kotwal ko daante. Sorry to use Hindi on an English channel. Lekin jab gaon mein bhediye aake bacche utha ke chale jaate hain, tab us samay ye nahi kaha jata hai ki bhai bacche gayab ho gaye. Bachchon ko utha ke bhediye le gaye. And they are talking about democratic fabric, democratic fabric being disturbed.
Shiv Kumar or Yadu Siddharamaiah keh rahe hain.
Nobody can claim
sir,
high moral ground.
People, both Siddharamaiah on the
Gopal
floor
ji,
is talking
ji,
about retail buying
Gopal
of
ji, why
MLAs
are you putting
good.
The bill of Congress MLAs? Gopal
and
ji,
your Siddharamaiah is
why are you
the
putting
floor,
the bill of Congress
shame.
MLAs? Why are you footing the bill of Congress MLAs?
Shiv Kumar tried every trick.
Why are you footing the bill of Congress MLAs?
Mr. DK Shiv Kumar.
Sir, angrezi bolne se desh andhari ho jata. Pure desh ko dikh raha hai. Pure desh ko dikh raha hai ki this political vulturism. Sab pure desh ko dikh raha hai. और एक बात याद
नहीं मगर ये भी बता दीजिए एक सेकंड निशांत वर्मा ये भी बता दीजिए मैं आपसे पूछूंगा नहीं कि आपका इशारा किसकी तरफ है भेड़िए कौन है और बच्चे कौन है मगर मैं ये भी स्पष्ट कर दूं निशांत जी कि ये बच्चे नहीं है ये दूध पीते हुए बच्चे नहीं है ये विधायक है ये बहुत वरिष्ठ विधायक है और इन्होंने सोच समझ कर ये निर्णय लिया है तो क्या आप इन पे भरोसा कर सकते हैं कि अभी भी लौट आए आज भी लौट आए तो 6 महीने बाद इनको वापस कौन रोकेगा ये 6 महीने तक टिक पाएंगे
अरे कैसे लौटेंगे क्या जवाब दीजिए दे रहे होंगे
ये जिन 10-15 लोग अगर वो लौट के आए
तो मतलब बिक गए
बीजेपी तो छोड़िए आज की तारीख में किसी सीट पे इलेक्शन करा दीजिए इनको एक वोट नहीं मिलेगा इनको जनता उठा के फेंक देगी दैट इज नॉट द सिचुएशन टुडे द सिचुएशन विच हैज बीन क्रिएटेड By through the political vulture,
आपकी गवर्नमेंट पूरी तरह फेल हुई है.
But my point is that the vultures cannot cry out that oh my God, look at the condition and status there. It is you, Mr. BJP, who has caused it. That is the root cause. Now whatever operation is happening in the ICU, you will see to it. You will also see to it. But एक चीज पक्की है गोपाल जी. आज की तारीख में आप fresh elections के लिए तैयार हैं क्या? आप fresh elections के लिए तैयार हैं कर्नाटका में? गोपाल जी आप यानी भारतीय जनता पार्टी आर यू रेडी
आप कुमार स्वामी को कहिए कि
कुमार स्वामी नहीं येदुरप्पा जी को टिकट देंगे ई 75 प्लस येदुरप्पा जी को टिकट देंगे ई 75 प्लस येदुरप्पा जी को टिकट देंगे इसलिए आप चुपचाप बैठे आज असेंबली में द रीजन व्हाई बीजेपी इज सो साइलेंट इन विधान सौधा बिकॉज दे फियर फ्रेश इलेक्शंस दे फियर They are only there to fish problems, to go into ground of Congress and trying to, you know, somehow make a government. अरे गोपाल जी भारतीय जनता पार्टी टुडे इज रेडी एनी फ्रेश इलेक्शन ओनली बिकॉज मिस्टर बी एस येदुरप्पा विल
सौदा आपके लिए होगा सौदा
आपका यही खेल खत्म होता है इसलिए आपको जितना जोड़ तोड़ हॉर्स ट्रेडिंग खच्चर ट्रेडिंग गधा ट्रेडिंग यू नो ऑल दैट अफगानी थिंग्स दैट यू हैव लर्नड ऑफ ट्रेडिंग प्लीज कंटिन्यू आई एम वार्निंग यू एंड द बीजेपी थ्रू यू इट विल कम बैक टू यू यू हैव सेट अ न्यू ट्रेंड इन लास्ट 3 years ऑफ डूइंग दिस हॉर्स ट्रेडिंग वेरी गुड सर द कंट्री हैज द कंट्री नाउ नोज दिस ट्रेंड वी विल बी इन द सेंस द वोटर्स नो हाउ टू टैकल दिस अप I am telling
we you, are grateful.
You started a trend. I am not denying. This is a country where the era is
People
of coalition
are rejecting
government.
You
and you are trying to make benefits out of lock, this coalition benefits through money game. Sir, money sirf aapke paas.
With the minority
there
of
are smart brains
MLA,
in this country who Janata know how to break such kind of, you know, charisma absolutely like this. And believe in me, today if you get successful through money game, kal Modi sarkar bhi giregi aise. याद रखिएगा ये देश बहुत होशियार है
दिस काइंड ऑफ सर्मन्स कीप इट एट टू गिव इट टू राहुल गांधी
नॉट रिक्वायर्ड आई हैव गॉट नथिंग टू डू विद राहुल गांधी बट यू डेफिनेटली टेल मिस्टर मोदी एंड मिस्टर शाह दैट दिस एम गेम द मनी गेम दैट यू हैव स्टार्टेड विल कम बैक टू यू गीता का सार याद रखिएगा गीता का सार याद रखिएगा परिवर्तन संसार का नियम है आपका भी परिवर्तन
वी आर सीइंग कुमारस्वामी स्पीच कंटिन्यूइंग ही इज नाउ डिफेंडिंग हिज गवर्नमेंट्स परफॉर्मेंस ही इज नाउ डिफेंडिंग हिज गवर्नमेंट्स परफॉर्मेंस ही इज टॉकिंग अबाउट हाउ हिज गवर्नमेंट हैज वर्क टायरलेसली ही इज टॉकिंग अबाउट देयर लॉन्ग टर्म प्रोग्राम्स बेयरिंग फ्रूट and what all they have done in villages to transform the local rural areas of Karnataka. Is this a long farewell speech? According to you, Venkatarayan, do you believe the downfall is evident? Perhaps the resignation is moments away now?
It's a shameful speech.
Yeah. Mr. Agarwal, I'm just coming back to you. Venkatarayan.
Obviously.
Udayji, it's a shame on democracy.
I feel very sorry shame. For Mr. Kumaraswamy. May I say what I have to say? I feel very sorry for Kumaraswamy, but the bottom line is that, 15 MLAs have walked out and submitted their resignations and even complained to the Supreme Court that the governor is not accepting their resignations. And there are whips issued by both the parties that these people should attend the assembly session, but they are not attending the assembly session. I think the speaker has every right to expel them or disqualify them as members of the Legislative Assembly of Karnataka. So then the Congress JDS coalition will obviously be reduced to a minority. So I think the governor, the speaker has every right to ask Mr. Kumaraswamy, now enough is enough, let us put the motion to vote, let voting take place, and if he is not willing to resign before he is defeated on the floor of the House, so be it. And, things should move forward. One of our friends was making the point that Mr. Yediyurappa did not have a majority, but that was 14 months ago, my friend. Let us look at things as they exist today. It's a different matter whether he's going to get a ticket if and when Karnataka goes to assembly polls next, because he has cast 75. So let's not worry about all those things. Let us face the situation as it exists today, as of now. I think political morality demands that since Kumaraswamy has lost his majority, he should simply submit his resignation. If he is refusing to do so and is going on speaking and speaking, I think it is the speaker has the authority to ask him to stop and put the motion to vote and declare the results of the outcome of the voting. He should do that without wasting any more time. This is what I think, Uday.
Absolutely. You know, and that's why many wonder at what the speaker really is doing, Mr. Murari. Because at the end of the day, yesterday or day after day, he says that he is getting frustrated. He's willing to sit till midnight. He is chastising the MPs, saying that MLAs rather, saying that they are, so many of them are demanding to speak, but they're not making any new argument. You know, it's all a repetition, and it just seems to an attempt to delay the inevitable. Also, today he has said that he's being pushed to the wall. He is ready to resign. He displayed his letter as well on the floor of the House. But why is he not cracking down? Why isn't he setting a time period? We all see how the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha functions. There are debates which happen there as well on various motions, but there is a time period. It's not that it stretches day after day after day. What explains this, Mr. Murari?
The Speaker has full power to regulate the proceedings as he deems fit. And as everyone has said, it's very, very tiring the way the Kumaraswamy is going on and on and on. Just not done. He can always grill it and ask him to stop, face the vote. Second point is, somebody has said they can press for a division. That is automatic. What will happen is, once he finishes the speak and he is ready to face the vote, first it will be decided by voice vote. Then they vote for division. The division is to see where you stand. You stand up and be counted. That's the idea. Then all these people who are out, they will be seen as negative. Abstention, they're not present. So that is for the future, so that the Congress can take action against them the next day or the day. Second point is, okay, this government is going to fall. That is a foregone conclusion. After that, what happens? The BJP is the single largest party. I have another point on that. Is it ethical for the governor to call the BJP again for a second time to form the government?